my name's Dr. Padilla. I'm a professor in computer science and psychology, and I've been a professor for over 5 years. In this video, I wanted to do something different than what I normally do, and really just to give you an update on the news of academia. There's a lot of news coming out, and maybe you're not in academia itself. Maybe you just haven't been paying attention, which is totally fine. Maybe you want to get in academia, like you're thinking of applying to PhD programs, and you just haven't been following all of the news. So I wanted to kind of get you up to speed on what's been going on in academia and potentially do follow-ups to this as more news comes out. And the goal of this is just to make sure that you're making informed decisions about how to progress in academia and ensuring that all of these things don't hit you by surprise. So let's jump on in. Okay, so 2024, 2025 was a big year for news in academia, and it's primarily related to grant funding and how there's a shift in the United States for grant funding. Now, what has been going on is that there's been several different mechanisms that grant funding has changed drastically in the United States. The first one to note is that in 2024, both NIH and NSF issued a realignment of their mission or their priorities. Basically, what happens is they fund various grants, of course, and the grants need to fit the mission or priorities of the funding agency. Now, historically, people have submitted grants because they knew what those were. They're released on their website, and many of the grants adhered to those previous priorities or missions, okay? In 2024, those changed. So many grants that had previously been accepted were no longer in alignment with the priorities of NSF, which is the National Science Foundation, and NIH, which is the National Institute of Health. And this was a big shock to researchers. In particular, one of the realignments of the priorities involved focusing on equal representation for all parties. That's kind of how they were described by NSF and NIH. So for example, NSF in particular issued a statement indicating that research that focused on one group and didn't help a larger population of the United States or the world was no longer in line with their priorities. I'll read a statement to this effect. This is from their priorities. These efforts should not prefer some groups at the expense of others, or directly, indirectly exclude individuals or groups. Research projects with more narrow impact limited to subgroups of people based on projected class or characteristics do not effectuate NSF's priorities. So what ended up happening is many of the already issued NSF grants were reevaluated based on these new criteria, and they failed to meet the new mission of NSF, and they were canceled or revoked. There's some reports that says it's around 1,700 NSF grants, and just a little under that for NIH grants. And that is, you know, a ton of money, millions and millions of dollars, of course. But there have been legal challenges, certainly. In particular, June 16th of this year, a federal judge issued a ruling that some of these were not legal. That is interesting, but it's certainly going to be challenged in courts. So it's not fully known at this point how many of these grants that were initially canceled will become refunded. That is certainly ongoing. And in addition to those cuts, there also is a new proposal for budget for 2025-2026 period. In that budget, the proposal for research funding has been cut from normal years. So in particular, the budget proposes to cut funding to the National Science Foundation from $9 billion to $3.9 billion. A major cut as well. Historically, around 25% of grants had received awards. This would cut it down to around 7% of grants would be receiving awards. So we're really seeing major cuts to federal grant funding, really across the board at both NSF and NIH. And it is unknown how many of those particular cuts are gonna hold, given that there's lots of court cases right now that are yet to be resolved. Now, in addition to the actual funding cuts, there's also infrastructural changes that have been happening to the federal agencies. In particular, there was a proposed cap to NSF grants at 15%. Now, what happens normally in normal years is that when you submit an NSF grant, you have to put aside some of the money for your institution. And this is to cover things like all of the administration, taking care of lab equipment, taking care of students, etc. So this is money for infrastructure and development to facilitate that particular grant. At some institutions, it's anywhere from 50 to 60% of the grant price. So if you are getting $1 million, you're looking at $500,000 set aside as indirect costs. That's what that means. And then you get $500,000 for the research itself, okay? Now, universities fully rely on those funds because it, you know, gives them money to run their university. There has been a proposal to cut that from whatever the university specifies, and it's different from university to university, to 15%. So that's a major reduction. And again, that's less funds that can be allocated to the universities as opposed to the overall grant. And the last major piece of news that I'll talk about in terms of NSF, there's a major restructuring of NSF. 37 divisions have been abolished. The way it works is basically all of science is broken up into subfields. And when you submit a grant, you submit it to these individual programs. In that program, there's these subdivisions where they have grant officers that have specific expertise related to the individual proposal that is being submitted. So you know when you submit a proposal, it's going to go to a particular group of people that have expertise in evaluating it. That has been restructured, 37 have been removed. It's unclear what the new structure is going to be, but suffice to say that it is a very different system that researchers are going to have to learn in terms of where to submit things, what type of research falls under what directorate, etc. Alrighty, so those are the major structural changes to these grant agencies. And this is, you know, when I recorded this video. So there's certainly gonna be more changes unfolding. Now let's talk about institutional fallout. There has been specific institutions that have been fighting back against some of these changes. In particular, Harvard has been one of them. And what has happened is the current US administration is suggesting that Harvard, as well as some other major institutions, have been violating some major issues that they bring up. And because of these violations, they are either halting or stopping grant funding to those institutions or stopping new visas being issued to students coming into those universities. Okay, so there's obviously a lot of litigation going on there, but note that there are reports of the administration really focusing on specific institutions for the various practices that they have at those institutions in terms of what they teach, admissions, how they deal with protests, etc. So let's talk about how this impacted admissions for 2024 and how it will likely impact admissions for 2025. For 2024, basically what happened is all of this news was coming out pretty late in the application cycle. That basically means that much of what was happening, we didn't know the conclusions of, which we still don't today. So a lot of departments scaled back admissions for PhD applicants. And that is basically because they have projected revenues coming in from grants, and some universities had a very serious reliance on these major grants, in part because it was prestigious to get the grants. But those projected revenues were no longer accurate, given that there's this reduction across the board and all these other things happening. So for admissions, massively scaled back. We're going to see the same thing happen for 2025, but the difference now is that we have a more accurate understanding of what the impacts will be from institution to institution and department to department. Really what's going on is all across the US, these institutions are trying to find ways to fund these different programs that are not as reliant on federal funding to make them more resilient to these different changes. So you'll see some places doing that better than other places. So I think the rule of thumb should be if you're seeing open positions this year, I don't think they're going to go away. I think people have accurately calculated how many applicants they can take on and how many offers they can get out. That certainly wasn't the case last year because everything happened so quickly. But I will say there's just gonna be fewer spots overall until these different institutions get the revenue generation up from other sources other than federal grants. I hope this was useful. If you liked this news roundup, let me know. Definitely hit the like button and subscribe for more content on academic success. I will probably do another one of these videos when there's more news to talk about as things unfold. Hopefully it is a uneventful year and there's no news to talk about, but if there is, I'll make more regular videos to kind of keep you up to speed on the news in academia. Academia can be tough, but you don't have to go through it alone. Keep learning, keep growing, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care.